Hello everybody and welcome to my Sunday review this 5th of May 2019, and I'd like to introduce it from the gymnasium of Brian Rose, which is above Mark Ellis Public House on Talbot Road. The gymnasium is closed at the moment, so that gives me a wonderful opportunity to start my video from here. First of all, thank you to everybody, as this channel now has 1,000 subscribers. I'd like to thank you all very, very much indeed, and also thank you to everybody who watches my videos. Thank you ever so much, all of you. Now, this Sunday's review will visit Talbot Road, which has some very, very important information for myself to tell you. Then we will go to the Premier Insight, where progress is now at a very rapid rate. From there, we then will visit the Sands Venue Resort Hotel, where an awful lot of work has taken place internally. Unfortunately, I won't be able to show this. We will then catch a tram to the Easy Hotel site, where work has not yet started to clear the site. However, that will soon happen. It is probably far too early yet for anything to be started, as they've only just been granted the okay to build. Also in this Sunday review, I have included some photos and videos from the town, which I've collected, I think it was Monday and Tuesday. The last little message is to tell you that as and from Monday, tomorrow, the 6th of May, I will be on a 10-day holiday. So my next Sunday review will be on the 19th of May. However, I will be still making some videos, because I hope to video the progress of my holiday. Now, where we're going is a place called Sea Houses. So I will title the videos Sea Houses Holiday 2019. And I think if you type that in, the videos should come up on YouTube. I do hope you watch them. Now again, previous to starting this Sunday survey, I want to thank everybody again for those two things, for the 1,000 subscriptions and for everybody who watches these videos. Thank you all very much, and I'm going to start the video now. Thank you. Bye bye. Saturday, the 4th of May 2019, and just by the North Pier, and I'm going to show you now Talbot Square, and what a marvellous job these contractors have done. Look, every bit of machinery now been taken away, and this area, I would say, is 100% completed now. A marvellous job. So nice to see it like this, it really is. This will be our little walk for this Sunday review. A walk from here, the North Pier, right up to Wilko's. Now, having said what I have just said, there is a little twist to this. Usually, I start our walk of Talbot Road from Wilko's to the North Pier, but today it's necessary for myself to start the reverse way. What I'm about to tell you was only released late yesterday, Friday. Today, Saturday, this news was reached to everybody via Blackpool's local paper. Just walked a few yards now and we're approaching the little black pug, and adjacent to that is where I want to be to explain this, and that is right outside the church. Just got a few more paces to go and then we will find ourselves here where I want to be. Now tomorrow is the 5th of May. Now the message that I'd like to relay is this. From next Sunday, the 12th of May, the whole of Talbot Road is having to be closed to all cars. Now it says cars on the Blackpool Council roadworks. I presume that it also means all Blackpool transport as well. This is the bank holiday weekend and I've just come out of Blackpool Transport shop and regretfully they have no information of yet, but Blackpool Council's website says that the whole of Talbot Road will be closed to cars. I presume that also, as said previously, that must and should mean to all Blackpool transport as well. This closure will last approximately 5 days from the 12th of May. 5 days approximately from the 12th of May. This is what the Blackpool local paper reports. Outside the Sacred Heart, the concrete has not met with specifications. I'm not going to get involved with technicalities. To complete the message relayed from the Blackpool newspaper, this is the final section. Talbot Road from May the 12th, for approximately 5 days, this road will be closed for quality and safety checks. So the closure will last 5 days approximately from Sunday the 12th. From Sunday the 12th for 5 days, Talbot Road completely closed for cars, and as I expect, also to all transport of Blackpool Transport. All the buses, they must be affected as well, I should imagine. But as said, this was not mentioned on the Blackpool Council, it just said cars, but I should imagine it must affect all the buses as well. Anyway, we must move on now, and I hope I have explained that, because obviously it's going to affect quite a lot of people. Now we find ourselves now at the top of Talbot Road, outside Mark Kelly's and looking over to Wilko, and I would like to show you this. This area, this time last week, was all blocked off, and you can see that all the new tiles are now in place. just turn round again outside Markedis, and this area here virtually all finished as well. I've just crossed the road now, there's Wilco, and that will complete our little tour of Talbot Road, explaining all the news that pertains to this road, which will be put into operation next Sunday, the 12th of May, for the approximate 5 days. Morning, everybody. Saturday, the 4th of May, 2019, and in the middle of the bank holiday weekend. The first of two in this month. And look at this, Saturday, and we see marvellous work done here. The steel erectors are virtually finished on this fourth and fifth story. On the outside, the actual framework of the outside, very, very nearly finished. Is they're just placing that girder. We are round the front now. Very interesting. As you can see, from one end to the other, all the steel framework is finished here. And also you can notice the metal sheeting already laid on the fourth and fifth floors, over which concrete will be laid to form the flooring. And now a view from the side. And as you can see again, virtually all completed now. Just in time to see another girder placed in this giant metal and steel jigsaw. Ever so close now to the completion of the outside framework. Hope you have enjoyed this visit, and now we must move on to our next venue. And if you would like to go to the zoo, please remember, this number 20 service is now in operation, and it starts right adjacent to the side of the Sands Venue Hotel. So from here, straight to the Blackpool Zoo gates. The Sands Venue Resort Hotel, and we are at our usual little viewing area on the first of two sides, and we're at the front with a view, our usual view, to the rear. All the work is being taken place inside. You may look at this and say, well, it's the same as last week and the week previous, but however, all the work is all internal. Just a few paces up, and I hope you can see what I mean. Lot of steel structures inside, lot of steel supports and everything inside. And a view now from the rear looking to the front. The Sands Venue Resort Hotel, which one day will be Blackpool's only five-star hotel on the promenade. And this is the second of the two sides of the hotel. And this will complete our visit for this Sunday review to the Sands Venue Resort Hotel. We will catch this tram and take it down to Waterloo Road to see if there's any work going on or any clearing up being done on the Easy Hotel site. We are on our way now. Now, not only is it one of the bank holidays this weekend, but also we have 6,000 young farmers here this weekend, which makes it extra busy. Yes, they arrived yesterday, Friday, and I expect they'll stay the whole of the weekend. Off we go again. Lots of cars parked out there. All the hotels on the seafront, all full with cars. The next stop coming up is the one that we need, Waterloo Road. Here we are, Waterloo Road. Have just crossed the road and we can see the site for this Easy Hotel. Nothing I don't think anything has been taken away. There's a few things shuffled around, or should we say maybe thrown around, but I don't think anything has been taken away. But I'm certain that in the very near future this will be attended to. Yes, the site of the Easy Hotel. Bye-bye.